Hi, I'm Danilo. I'm part of the developer relations team in AWS. And today we're talking with Sasha. Sasha, can you please introduce yourself and talk about the company Unitary that you co-founded?
Sure. So I'm Sasha. I'm one of the co-founders, one of two, and the CEO of Unitary. And I co-founded Unitary in 2019, so about 3 years old now. And we're an online safety company. So we're analyzing content on the internet to check for anything harmful. So for example, looking for hate speech or violent content, and we're particularly focused on videos at the moment. And the idea is to make the internet a safer place for users and anyone who wants to post things online.
Oh wow, as a user of social media, and I think now having this kind of control on user-generated content is really useful and important. You have a PhD at the University of Cambridge.
Yes.
Did you work with Stephen Hawking?
I did.
Wow.
I did my PhD on looking at black holes and something called the information paradox. So basically answering the question, or trying to answer the question, what happens to something when it falls into a black hole and where does the information about it go? It was a very cool experience, and especially it was incredible to work with Stephen Hawking, who's a sort of the very, very big brain in this field and has sort of amazing intuition.
So what are the challenges that you face in processing a large amount of videos, I suppose?
There's a lot of challenges. I guess on the one hand, the challenges are around, can we understand the content? And sometimes, this is from a sort of machine learning point of view, sometimes the content and the harm associated with the content is very context dependent. So for example, if someone puts a caption alongside an image or a video, it could change the meaning quite drastically. So we need to understand all the sort of metadata and surrounding content of the video so that we can understand the intent of the video itself, and is this racist, or is this just a commentary on racism, for example. And the things we can interpret from the video will have profound implications to, you know, what happens to that video. Is it taken down, or is it just reported in some way?
So talking about how you analyze this video content, so what kind of content do you look into a video? You said no video, audio, and what else?
Sure, so in every video, we have to take into account sort of the visual frames of the video, as well as the audio that comes with the videos. So that might be noises or speech. And also, often there's extra text on the screen or accompanying captions and comments. And so we try and look into all these different pieces of data and assemble them together to develop an understanding of what's going on inside that video.
Is there anything that you want to share on what you're working next?
We've got lots of exciting things like coming up, and looking to look at longer videos and live video as well, and hopefully be able to process larger and larger volumes. So it's really exciting.
Thank you, Sasha, for spending some time with us, and looking forward to meeting again to see how your company is growing in the next 6 months.
Thanks so much.